Hello and welcome to a new video from Dynamic Array Function series, video number 11. In this video, I'm challenging you. Are you aware of this trick? The multiple criteria search using XLOOKUP. Actually, it's a quite simple one, but I'm sure that many people are not aware of. At end of this video, I'm going to show you also how you can do it using the traditional VLOOKUP function if you are not an Office 365 user. In the practical example today, I have a small set of data containing sales information. It comes in four columns. First column, date, and then product name, color, and then quantity. And I need to calculate the revenue. So I need to bring the price. The price is in the price list in a separate table on the right-hand side. And you can see that the price is decided based on two conditions. First one is the name of the product and then the color of the product. So you can see that cargo bike white is different from cargo bike blue. So the first one is 400 pounds and the second one is 420. So I need now, using the XLOOKUP function, to bring the price into this table, the first table, and then multiply by the quantity in order to calculate the revenue. So inside cell E2, I'm going to write equal and then XL. The first choice is XLOOKUP. You can see it is highlighted in blue. If you press tab, it will write XLOOKUP and it will open the bracket. And I'm going to follow the screen tip. The first argument is the lookup value. And let's think about it. We need two criteria inside the lookup value. We need the name of the product and then the color of the product. In order to do this, I'm going to join both together. So I'm going to select B2 and then AND operator, which is the concatenation or the join operator. And then C2, and this both together is compromising my criteria or my lookup value. And because we are working in Office 365, I can, instead of selecting only B2 and C2, I can select the entire column for the product and the entire column for the color. In order to do this, let me start over again. I'm going to select B2 and then press and hold shift and control, one arrow down to select the entire column, and then control backspace to go back. And then again, I'm going to use the AND operator and I'm going to select C2, press and hold shift and control, one arrow down, control backspace and comma. And now my lookup value, the entire column of product joined with the entire column of the color. And then I'm going to move to the next argument, which is the lookup array. Same, I need the two columns together for product and color from the lookup table. So I'm going to select I, press and hold shift and control, one arrow down, and then AND, the join operator or the AND. And again, I'm going to select G2, hold shift and control together and one arrow down. And now I need the return array, comma, to move to the next argument, which is the return array. So my lookup value is inside the transaction table, the two columns together, product and color, joined with the AND operator. And my lookup array is from the lookup table, also the two columns together for product and for color, joined together with the AND operator. The last argument is the return array. So I'm going, obviously, to select the array containing the price. I'm going to select K2, press and hold shift and control, one arrow down. And I can close the bracket for XLOOKUP and hit enter. It will spill automatically till the end of the table, as you can see, up to row 162. Now I have the prices. If you check the first one, mountain bikes red, you can see here mountain bikes red 220. It's correct. Let's check another one, road bikes blue. Here you go, road bikes and blue 320. Second line 320, which is correct. So I think we have the right prices. Now I want to multiply this with the quantity. I can edit again inside the formula bar and I'm going to use the asterisk and I'm going to multiply by the quantity. For sure, I need to select the entire column as well. Press and hold shift and control, one arrow down, and then control backspace. I think I am ready. I'm going to hit enter. Let me go down again. I'm going to select E and D together and then control equal. I have now the total quantity and the total revenue, 119,000. Very easy and straightforward. Very nice trick that can save you a lot of time. And the only condition that you have Office 365, so you can use the XLOOKUP and the whole dynamic array calculation engine. If you are not an Office 365 user, this is not a problem at all. You still can do the same task using the traditional VLOOKUP, and I'm going to show you how right now. Let's move to the second tab, VLOOKUP, and I have the same exact set of data. But before using the VLOOKUP, I need to prepare my price list. Something needs to be added, which is a helper column that will help me to search inside the product and color together. So I'm going to select these two columns together, right click and unhide. I have already prepared a column for this purpose called product slash color. So in the first cell, I'm going to write equal, then I'm going to select the product I2, and then I'm going to join both together. I'm going to use the AND operator, and I'm going to join this with the color and hit enter. I can just double click to send it down till end of the table. Let me check the end. Yes, it's okay. So I'm now ready to start my VLOOKUP. So let me go to E2 again, and then equal VL, my first choice is VLOOKUP, tab, the lookup value will be the concatenation between the column B and column C, the product and the color, but this time I'm going to select the single cell, I'm not going to select the entire column, so B2 and then C2 and comma. Next argument is my table array, so I'm going to select the entire table just below the header from H2, press and hold shift and control, one arrow to the right and one arrow to the bottom. This will select the entire table. I need also to press F4 in order to make this reference absolute reference, because I'm going to copy this down this time. Then comma, the column index, where is my return value? My return value is in column K, which is the fourth column. 1, 2, 3, fourth column is the price. So I'm going to type 4 for the column index and then comma. And unlike the XLOOKUP, the default match setting is the approximate match. So I need to type false, or I can just select and double click. It will write false. This is unlike the XLOOKUP, which has the exact match as a default value. And then I can close the bracket and hit enter. Now I have the price as we did last time. I can check my first price, mountain bikes red 220. Here you go, the mountain bikes red, you can see it is 220, so the retrieval is happening correctly. I can just edit again and multiply by the quantity in order to calculate the revenue and hit enter. You can just double click and send it down, or you can just use your keyboard, one arrow to the left and then control, one arrow to down, one arrow to the right, and then control and shift together to select up to the first row, and then control D to copy down, and then one arrow down to go to the total row, and then I can select E and D together, alt equal to do the auto summation for the two columns together. You will notice that we have the exact amount, 119, which is exactly what we calculated using the XLOOKUP. So no problem if you are using Office 365, it's much easier. You can just use directly XLOOKUP. If you are not, no problem, you can still do it using the traditional VLOOKUP, but you have to add a helper column to the left of the lookup table as we did in column H here. That was all for today. If you like the video, please like it and subscribe to the channel and leave me a comment. And also you will see here some useful links. You will see the link for this series. I have 10 videos before this one. You can start watch from the beginning. And also there's a link to the pivot table series and also to the Power Query basic series. Please, you can take a look on them. I think they can be very useful for you. Thank you very much for your time, and see you in the next video, and bye.